Okay. See, who we got in here today? Oops, what's going on? All right, let's see. Havoc, which I don't see where Havoc is. Necro. Necro said, where is everybody? Hang on. Havoc, nope. UT. Looks like playing Final Fantasy. What else? Shinigami. I don't see Shinigami. Nylon, filthy shoe. Hey, what's going on, Senpai? You know, you might get your chance here to join in here. We don't have too many people ready to go, so I'll get you in here, Senpai. Hopefully, all is well with you. What's going on, filthy shoe? Oops, hang on. I'm trying to reset this thing. Looks like it's snowing out in Michigan again. How much snow are you supposed to get tonight? Hopefully not too much. Four feet? What the heck? Oh my goodness. 4 feet. Oh my goodness, that's a lot. Hey, felt this you got first, Dan. Hey, what's going on, Instinct Assassin? Good to see you in the chat.
Welcome to the King of Iron Fist Tournament 7, Negan.
What is going on, Instinct? Good to have you all in the chat here so far. I know we just got started, so thank you so much for coming through. Everybody else who signed up here, not around. Oh. Except for Filthy Shoe.
Get ready for the
Unfortunately,
next
Senpai here
battle,
joining
battle,
us.
battle.
Literally have no snow right now. Okay, yeah. Like, I'm seeing a winter storm warning on my PC here. Again, it's still home to Michigan, but now it shows cloudy. What the heck? It just changed. Maybe just passed. Who knows? Instinct, I'm doing great. Thank you so much for asking. Good to be back here.
Round one.
Running some practice sessions.
Fight.
Oh, nice to catch. Oh, good catch. Nice. Oh, landed. Oh, okay. Let me get you in here after this lobby. This match, excuse me.
KO.
Yeah, I thought you signed up too. That was really
Round
weird.
two.
All right, I'll get you in here soon.
Fight.
Nice. Yeah, no.
KO. Round three. Fight.
Oh no, hell sweet. You can't block it. Nice, good catch there. Nice, good low for the Vishu.
Round 4. Fight.
Nice, interrupt. Alright, nice stuff, Delphishu. Nice stuff. I can definitely see you've improved since last week, so keep going. Alright, Lan. My apologies here. Let me get you in here. Thank you so much for your patience. Like a senpai here. It's chilling. It's chilling. It's cold.
Welcome to the King of Iron, Negan.
Trying to see if anybody else here who signed up is already online. Nope. So we'll keep going here. Might throw in a few players here who may have not signed up, but like to see if they want to join the lobby for a little bit. Yeah, you do really well with the lobby folks. I think you're starting to understand. Kind of playing a good balance of offense and defense, which is good. Ooh, Nina, yes. I need more Nina practice. I'm about to die in silence. And by the way, folks, there are some new commands, which I did post up here recently. Oh, I did not post that up. Never mind.
Round 1.
I thought I posted up a command. Fight. Apparently I did not. Nice. Oh, nice counter.
KO.
Nice.
Round 2. Fight. KO. Round 3. Fight.
Nice.
Not cool.
Oh no.
KO.
The trade on the not cool.
Round 4. Fight.
No exception. up smash bubble throw! KO. Alright, nice. Good stuff, Senpai. Good stuff.
Isn't it?
Alright, let me see what's wrong with my community. Oh, that's right, I didn't save it. Oh, it's under new sounds too. It's the wrong command. Here we go. New sounds. This should work. Yes. Put in a few new sounds here before the session. I was kind of behind on some of that. Hopefully they work. If they don't, then I'll fix it. Good stuff, Senpai. Thank you so much. Spare your life. Die in silence. I got the sound for you.
Die in silence.
Oh, Rodney sent me some clips from the Tekken 8 trailer for Nina. Told me to make him a sound clip, so I did. Everybody were like, what, the Paul Phoenix? I never thought that Senpai would ever play Paul Phoenix here.
Round one. Fight.
I was drinking some water. I almost spit on water when I saw Paul Phoenix. All right, filthy shoe. Oh, counter hit magic four there. Paul does have a magic four combo, which is quite deadly. Watch your whips. Oh my goodness. Watch your whip, filthy shoe. Watch your whips.
Round two. Fight.
Nice. Okay, patience. Okay, wow, filthy shoe with the string. Filthy shoe string.
KO.
Got it.
Round three. Fight.
Alright, Senpai relax with the 1-4. Oh, nice whip punish there and the hop kick with the drop the comp. Okay. Demo man. Oh, and the choke roll.
Round four. Fight.
Oh, nice catch there. Oh, nice pick up. Certain characters have a guard break after the kip up into the cross dive there. Paul is one of them. If you block the move, then they can float with the jab into a combo. Sometimes it's better to take the hit, but Jin can actually parry the cross dive. So he should be able to be safe in that regards. Oh, and gotta watch your whips.
You win.
Good stuff, Senpai. Good games to Filthy Shoe. Oh. Excuse me, Lan. Or was it? No, that was Filthy Shoe. My bad. Lan is up next with the Armor King. Let's go, Lan. Good stuff, good stuff. Oh, I forgot to check and see if some others would like to join here. Oh, we got Shinigami here. All right. I'm going to send him an invite after this match. Wow, Senpai Relax with the Tekken God Prime Lydia. Wow. Awesome stuff. Yeah. Lydia is one of those characters you don't get to see that often in rank. Honestly, I have only seen her like one time.
Round one.
In my entire gameplay season one, which is kind of crazy. I think she's still a very useful character. He's gotten nerfed, but he's still good in some regards. Good punishment. Nice. Nice sidestep. Nice. Okay, land here. With the, ooh, nice duck there by Senpai.
K-O.
And the down one.
Round two. Fight.
Oh, running one. And the down one plus three. Guaranteed. Or the forward one plus three. Forward. Keep forgetting some of her commands. It's been a while. Down one plus two is another character. Play Julia. Oh, nice counter. Okay. Nice combo there by Lane. Nice, nice. Capital punishment for pressure. Yeah, you got the Lariat here. Be careful you whiff. Nice low. Don't whiff now. Don't whip.
K-O.
Nice, there you go.
Round three.
Good stuff, Lane.
Fight.
Hey, string there. Mid-high string. He does have a mid-mid string variant. Oh, good catch. Jab, jab. By land. Okay. Somebody likes about to chase here with those running ones. Oh, try to go for the throw there. Spacing out. And the down back to the lame duck.
Round four.
Funny how that move is called lame
fight.
Duck. Oh, nice counter. 1-1. Go for the OP option. Wow, nice shot there by Senpai. Pressure here.
KO.
Nice. Good punish.
You
back
win.
1-2 with King, Army King, minus 12. And good punish. Alright. Let me get receiving Gami here. Okay.
Welcome to the King of Iron Fist Tournament's Craig Marduk.
Need more practice with this character. I don't have the muscle memory and the comfortability using this character yet, so keep working on it. I've been playing some other characters, so
get ready for the
get
next
back
battle.
In the swing of things. Oh, going for Zafiner.
Round
I'm gonna smack myself, so I think it's fine.
Fight.
Wow. Great. Oh, nice catch.
KO. Round 2. Fight. KO. Round 3. Fight.
Oh, nice counter.
KO.
All right, good stuff, Senpai. See if a certain victory would like to join. I don't see him anymore. Maybe C16 would like to join. We'll find out.
Welcome to the King of Iron Fist Tournament 7.
Let's see.
Kazumi Mishima.
Azure, okay. I wonder if they have a Kazumi type character in Tekken 8.
Round 1. Fight.
Alright, see if you can learn how to sidestep. There we go. Work on a sidestep. Nice.
Perfect.
Work on a sidestep.
Round 2. Fight.
Oh, dang. I thought I missed that because of the extra hit. Nice. Oops, nice step. Nice. Working that sidestep. Nice. There we go. With homie. Trade, yep. Hey, what's going on, C16? See you in the chat.
KO. Round 3. Fight.
Oh, nice healthy.
Down!
in a sight.
KO.
Alright, good stuff, Filthy Shoe. Nice try. And we got Shinigami and we got C16. Thank you so much for joining the lobby here.
Welcome to the King of Iron Fist Tournament 7. Bakum Lam.
Surprisingly, I've seen more Fox in ranked lately. He used to be non-existent, but I think a lot of players are giving him a chance some more or just kind of throwing him in there because they don't have any other players or characters to work with. So, and because of my lack of experience against Bach, sometimes I get challenged really hard with that character. I was like, gotta learn how to react to his strings again. Good thing is that he's more punishable, so
a lot of his strings
and moves are launch punishable now.
Round one.
More launch punishable.
Fight.
Shut the fuck up. BBC torpedo. BBC torpedo.
Nice.
Shit. Clinch.
KO. Round two. Fight.
I can't even fucking show this dude's on strength. Fuck. What the fuck? This dude's on strength.
Nice back one.
Fuck.
Get that ass bent. Get that ass bent.
Shut the fuck up.
KO.
He was ducking. I thought he was gonna block it.
Round three. Fight.
Get that ass bent. Get that ass bent.
I can't even fucking do anything. Fuck. BBC torpedo. This dude's on strength.
Oh, nice power crush. I didn't commit to the first time. Very nice.
Fight.
Get that ass bent. Get that ass bent. Get that ass bent.
KO.
It's funny because none of these people are.
What's up, man? What's up? Very good patience. Good use of Armor King's lows there and very good reads on the hopkicks. That mod is so loud. Yo, Montel, what's going on? Thank you so much for the 15 months on a 14th month streak. Thank you so much, Montel. I'm joining the queue. Thank you so much for joining.
Welcome to the King of Iron Fist Tournament 7.
All right.
Negan.
Your commitment to making an army of decent Tekken player commands respect. Thank you so much, Montel. I am definitely doing my best here. And I appreciate and very blessed to have the opportunity to do that, to help players too. That's the one thing that I'm really fortunate to be able to do, is to teach all the players. I may not be a pro player or really, really strong player like I know a lot of players are, but I do what I can.
Round one. Fight.
Okay. Wow. Oh my goodness. C16. Nuts. Wow.
KO.
I was afraid that C16 was going for another lightning screw. I was like, should I go low here? Oops. Oh damn, nice counter. Oh goodness. Nice. Oh, that's minus 14.
KO. Round 3. Fight.
Oops. Oh my goodness, are you serious? Man, C16, good reach on the lightning screw. I can't help but smile. Oh, nice orbital. I tried to block. Too late. Going downstairs. Oh no.
You win, Thurston.
Good stuff, C16. I was smiling and laughing every time I got hit by the lightning screw. I was like, oh my goodness, he's so crazy. Here I am throwing that plus frame to like, F your plus frames. Let me go for a lightning screw. It's like, damn. Good stuff, C16. Let me wash my glasses. Y'all know how much I hate Negan. Oh, I have no idea, C16. Did Keith B say something
Welcome
about that?
To the King of Iron Fist, I did not know. Tournament 7. Negan.
He didn't pass any memos to me or anything. I was just using him last week and having a grand old time. Supposedly, they're going to do another spin-off at The Walking Dead with Maggie and Negan. It's supposed to be another series, just those two and their adventures, supposedly. So, after the main Walking Dead series had finished, they're starting to do more spin-offs, and that's going to be one of them. Very interesting. Lunatics and Marty, how's it going? Good to see you in the chat. Thank you so much for coming through. Shinigami here with the Bob. I definitely need more Bob practice because, again, another one of those characters you don't get to see too much of. And I know Shinigami has been really working on this character.
Now, round
so
one.
I'm probably going to get washed here, so fight. Pardon me here.
Oh,
Oh, that went low. Oh.
KO. Round.
I'm punishing it wrong. I'm so bad.
KO. Round 4. Fight. Perfect.
Easy peasy lemon squeeze.
You win.
All right, good stuff, Shinigami.
To the King of Iron Fist Tournament 7. Josie Rizal.
I like Josie because I get to press a lot of buttons. She's got good punishment. Very good while standing punishment in the form of a 13 frame launch. Decent damage.
Oh gosh.
Round 1. Fight. Perfect. Round 2. Fight.
Nice. Oops, my combo is wrong. Wrong combo.
KO. Round 3.
waiting for Filthy to do something. Nice, okay. Nice, okay, good, good, good. Oops, last hit didn't work out. Nice, okay, good.
KO.
Alright, good stuff, Filthy, good stuff. Trying to make you play more aggressively. I'm playing defense and want to see what you got.
Welcome to the King of Iron Fist Tournament 7.
Bears.
Panda.
You'll get counter hit and lose every time? Yeah. I know. If people come to you, then that's ideal, right? But then if they're like, well, let me see what happens if you come to me, then it kind of puts pressure on you coming in. Especially when you're in the life deficit, it can be more difficult. So, gotta learn how to play both ways sometimes. That means you're mashing too slow? Oh, that's hilarious.
Fight.
Oh, nice counter.
KO. Round 2. Fight.
Okay. Oh no, combo. Nice patience. Nice object. Going downstairs? Yes. Bro? No. Wow, that's a long.
KO. Round 3.
I was like, that's a long, long walk here. Good stuff, Lan. Good stuff. I know Bears can be a little silly, so. Give Senpai some time to play. I know he missed his last rotation. Oh, look, now it says Winter Storm on my computer. Winter Storm Watch in Michigan. It's crazy. Bears are sick. You know, bears are a funny character, right? If you don't know how to deal with bears, and those bear players have a lot of tricks up their sleeve, it can make for a very difficult fight. Of course, having characters that can really deal with some of those options is very helpful. But of course, like I said, if you kind of lack the knowledge on how to deal with the bears, then they're hard to beat. I guess that goes the same with a lot of other characters that have weird things, weird hitboxes. Alright, Senpai Relax with the true tech god Claudio. Ridiculous. You didn't get snow up there, right? Oh, not in Arizona, Marty. No snow where I'm at. I'm in the west, so no snow for me. Thank goodness. Thankfully, I'm not up at like Flagstaff or anything like that. I prefer to be a little bit more south. Did you say bears are gimmicky? Yes. It can kind of overwhelm you after a while if you're not careful. I mean, if you have a bear player that plays fundamentals, okay, that's fine. But I think having some of those tricks is part of a bear player. And you gotta have them. I think Bear's worst matchup would be Miguel. See, Miguel's got super strong combo against those characters. And any character that has a reversal parry, punch parry or so, really good against Bears. Strong combos, also good against Bears. Because of the big boy, big girl combo. KO. At the end of the day, Bears don't have a lot. It's really gonna be more or less your timing of your offense to deal with stronger players. Against weaker players, you can kind of get away with a lot more stuff. Oh my goodness, C16! He's like, I'm gonna do the same move and it's gonna hit! Oh my goodness. The duck. I don't know, C16 was like not giving up on that back 1 plus 2.
You win.
Good game. I need to give Claudio another chance too. Claudio is actually pretty good. Very simple to use. Of course, you can always go for the more advanced stuff, but you can play him pretty simple. He's very effective. Very strong wall game in the form of sidestep 4, sidestep back 1. Strong combos. Good hop kick, probably the best hop kick in the game. Cause you know, it's kind of funny, I think a lot of characters that have a hop kick, they do advance forward when they kick, if you press up forward and whatever the kick button is. Claudio doesn't seem to move forward that much, if at all. Like if you can go for up forward, it almost looks the same. But I guess his range is so much, he doesn't need it. You know less than nothing about Claudio? Eh. Good time to lab a little bit of Claudio. He doesn't have a lot of moves. If you go into move list, he doesn't have too much. But that makes him kind of effective in that way. Most of his tools are pretty decent. And of course, we got the MJ mod here. Put it back on. Senpai Relax with the True Tekken God Lars and Shinigami here. True Tekken God Lee. I've known Senpai playing Lars here. Oh! Blocked the staggered low, but couldn't get the punish. Nice. Good pick up there. Okay. Shinigami here with the pressure. Good block. Oh, no punish. Oh, well, small punish there. Suboptimal. Round two. Staggered lows you can definitely launch. Okay. Okay, go for But the magnetic knee, that back four, swiping them shoes clean. Nice, going for the low mid string. Are we going to the wall? Yeah. Wow, nice damage. Very nice.
Round three. Fight.
Oh, nice catch by Senpai with the down 4-2-1 shoulder. Oh, missed the launch, but still got the punish on the shoulder. That shoulder is launch punishable. You see, 16 gonna be taking some notes here with Senpai's Lars. Nice, wow, good low parry there. Whiffed the first hit and was able to low parry the second. Nice counter. Nope, try to go for the slide there, sorry. And 4-4-4-3, nice.
Round four. Fight.
Oh, try to go for the down back four, but Shinigami interrupted from the start of the round. Nice. Try to play compact here. Senpai sticking with Shinigami here, close up. Trying to pressure him. Shinigami here able to get out. And nice spring kick. The break on throw. Wow, nice rage drive. Over the wall. Oh, doesn't get the full carry there. Front plus. Oh my goodness. Wow, the running three.
Fight.
Instant. Good match here between these two. Nice, that you cannot interrupt that. Down back four is plus five on hit. And then the full crouch down 4-2. Beat out any of your attacks there. Oh, the wall here. Oh no, drops. Doesn't get the dash in. Oh wow, look at the interrupt there. Oh, but the orbital. This might save Senpai. That's it. Nice. Dang. That was close. Something happened to Shinigami where he couldn't dash in to complete the wall carry. And then, of course, that gave Senpai Relax the opportunity to make the comeback, and he did with the orbital. You droped it. I know, exactly. I don't know why. You know what? Let's discuss that. Sometimes I've experienced that myself too, where for some reason or another, the dash doesn't come out when you want to go in for a wall carry or something, right? I've seen it happen to not myself, but other people when I see them play online or in matches. It just doesn't work. Like, even if I play offline, it does the same thing. So it's not like an offline or online thing. It does happen, and I don't know why. I don't know what the science is behind that. I don't know. It's really weird. Like, sometimes I'll even like mash on dash and then it doesn't come out. I'm like, what the heck? What's going on, D-Spec? And Edithism, how's it going? Good to see you in the chat. And LabWolf, how's it going? Senpai Relax here with the True Tekken God Ling. Got a lot of characters, True Tekken God.
Round
nice.
One. Fight.
Ling Xiaoyu. Another one of those tricky characters that, again, if you're not sure of, then you're gonna be in a world of hurt. Lots of weird stances from back turn, and you know, some of her moves really want you to try to attack, but then she's got evasive properties to some of those.
KO.
She can be very annoying.
Round two.
Some characters do a really good job against Fight. Her. Others, you kind of have to be careful when you want to attack. And play a little defense, right? Okay, trying to go for the jump over. That mistrust, the back turn 4, is launch punishable. Yeah, Jin can go for an easy launch punish with the can-cans. Okay, going for jabs. Hey, Mr. J, how's it going? Happy pre-fight Friday to you as well. Thank you so much. It was a great time playing you a couple days ago in some matches.
KO.
Very fun indeed. Actually, a Monday, so 3 days, more than a couple. Fight. 3 days ago, it was fun. Hopefully, you're trying to get back in the swing of things with this game. Senpai Relax here, just going around in circles, spinning, just trying to get Guilty to react in some shape or form. And see, the back turn 3 is really tricky because that move goes under highs and lows too. It's almost like a high and low crush in some respects. I don't think you can jab her out of that if she's in the air. You can go for mid. And that move also is safe, and it wall bounces too. It's a multi-use move. No first attends this Friday, D-Spec. The wife's birthday weekend bash, fun, whatever you want to call it. I'm going to be celebrating her birthday this weekend, starting tomorrow. So figured it'd be good to just take a break from the first attend so we can do some things in Friday evening. Saturday and Sunday and Monday. So Monday is actually her birthday, but we're gonna celebrate this weekend. I appreciate it, D-Spec. Thank you so much for the birthday wish. I'm not sure where Nikki is at the moment, but if she's hearing me, then I'll let her know. And thanks, Mr. J. And thanks, Edithism. Appreciate all of you giving her warm happy birthday wishes. Yeah, thanks, Senpai. Really appreciate it. Yeah, we have a number of things planned out. So, Friday, of course, doing a little dinner, maybe some other activities. Saturday, a number of things in Scottsdale. Going to a fancy dinner. And then Sunday, I forget what we're doing Sunday. Oh, we might be going in there. Maybe checking out a movie or something like that. I'm not sure. I have to check and see what the itinerary is that she has. And Monday will be some dinner with her parents at a nice location. And thanks, Phil Sisu. Appreciate it. It'll be her first birthday celebrated here in Arizona. And you know what's funny about my birthday? It's right around Combo Breaker. So sometimes I'm in Combo Breaker and I'm celebrating my birthday. Other times it's like a day before Combo Breaker or the day before I travel. So I get to celebrate kind of my state I'm in. For the past few years, you know, minus COVID, I've always been either at Combo Breaker or about to go to Combo Breaker. And this year will be no different. C16 says my laptop blew up. Oh no. You know,
KO.
I hope you're not injured by the laptop blowing up or blowing up. That's the one thing I've always wanted to do was collect different sayings that users tell IT whenever there's an issue. Right? I've always wanted to collect a number of those tickets that they put in and what they say. Like, the most generic tickets you can ever hear about, like, oh, my computer doesn't work. It's like, okay, well, what do you mean it doesn't work? Right? They have to drill down until finally it's like, oh well, it's because I just can't open this one file. And it's like, that doesn't mean that your computer doesn't work. You went from my computer doesn't work to I just can't open this file. Oh, okay. Oh,
perfect.
It died, right? Yeah. Oh, D-Spec has an encyclopedia of that. Oh man, honestly, I'm surprised there hasn't been a published book. Or maybe there is, but then I don't know about it. But I figured that's like perfect. All right, Filthy Shoe, thank you so much for coming through. I'm going to see who else is online. I think Montel's is on, right? Is Montel on? He did sign up. I'm going to try to see. Maybe Montel is not on. There you go, D-Spec. Yeah, I'm happy to give you some bright ideas. Do it. I mean, I would not be surprised if it was a bestseller, because it's so much content. It's not even yours, right? I mean, it's like just people just do it for you. You just gotta find a good publisher and, you know, white out people's names and stuff. Oh yeah, Montel is on, so he is online. All right, so let me check and see where everybody else is. Okay. All right, so we got a really good lobby going on tonight.
Get ready for the next battle.
You have to somehow make six figures this year? Wow. Is it you putting down the pressure of wanting to achieve six figures? Yeah, definitely. I would say for anybody, you know, come up with multiple streams of income, whether it's, you know, through
fight
investments or stocks, or I mean, be careful of those, obviously. You know, anything that can earn you some passive income. I know a lot of people are still trying to go and do some YouTube, you know, trying to get some of that YouTube money, Twitch obviously, but doing something creative is also rewarding in itself. Placing hits on people if need be, damn. Stacking, buying property, yeah, real estate is good, you know, especially, you know, I don't know how real estate is these days, I haven't been able to keep track of the market.
KO. Round two. Fight.
Yeah, five god kids? Dang, respect. That's crazy. Definitely a good godfather. Yeah, but when you do have that book, let me know. I'd love to get an autographed version of your book and profit sharing is also a plus. Nice low parry there. We're going for rage art. Oh no, just go for the rage art.
Great.
I think the rage art would have killed there, though. You can see that
round three.
C16 had very little health. Could have probably won it. You get the first copy? Oh, nice. That's great. No, I'm looking for it. You're gonna have 10 god kids by the time you're 30? Oh my goodness. That is ridiculous. Yeah, I've done okay for myself the traditional way. Just kind of work my way through and climb up the ladder. Went from a lowly, you know, administrator level 1 to a manager. Oh, that's good. Keep climbing the ladder. Eventually might be a senior. Part of senior management. Got people doing work for me. I do work myself too, of course, but I get to have other people to do the grunt work for me. And it's a good learning experience for them too. It's like, you know, when I was your age, I did this too. Dog walkers make good money. Yeah, I mean, if you're a fan of pets, then dog walking is also good. Life coach, yeah, that's also good too. I would say if you're really good at motivational speaking, or being able to, I wouldn't say as far as, you know, being a therapist or something, but you gotta be licensed for that. Life coach is good too. But motivational speaker is definitely, yeah, a big one. You wish you could be a dog walker? Dang. Met your ass misread and saw grandkids. I'm like, oh, yeah. Senpai relaxes. I'm like, whoa, 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 what? God kids, not grandkids. Dang. Damn. Oh, D-Spec's still in his 20s. He can't be having no grandkids now. Something wrong with that.
Fight.
They could be adopted grandkids. But I mean, still. The older you get, the more you just start looking at shit that goes in houses. Yeah, that's true. That is very true. Honestly, you know, Nikki, she's really good at decorating homes. When we got her home in Arizona,
fight.
It was empty, obviously, and she filled it up really nicely with decorations and furniture, and everything is in its place now. Don't really need too much. Maybe some seasonal decorations. Maybe some additional furnishings for the outside backyard. Thinking about like a fire pit, some of those warmers that you see at the restaurants. So when you be outside and it's chilly, you can turn those on and stay out in a nice, decently cool weather. Exactly, that's such a nice table. Yeah, honestly, I've looked at that differently too, D-Spec. At first, I was thinking like, oh, I'm gonna live like the quote unquote bachelor life and be like, I don't need any of this stuff. But now it's like, it just feels empty without having this stuff, right? And you gotta have a balance of function and form. You can't have too much over the top, but you know, at the same time, it's gotta look nice too. Nice duck. Alright, so she got me there. Lily is another one of those characters that also irks me a lot too, because of her sidestepping, you know. But of course, if you can step back, that's good too. And Shinigao! Wow! She got me with the back three. He's like, God dang it, girl. Low tier god lived so long thinking a rug could never be more than 200. Mr. J, yes, with the signature, get that blue shit out of here. I know, right, low tier god? It's amazing how much furniture is. Honestly, the one thing that Nikki has done was acquire a number of paintings to hang on walls. You know, that stuff
Suck my fucking
mid!
Sorry.
Yeah, rugs are crazy too, right? Yeah, I thankfully we haven't gotten that far to buy expensive rugs. We bought some area rugs and all that good stuff, but none of it was expensive. We go to Ross, which is very prevalent up here. You don't really get to see a Ross out in the Midwest. Ross is affiliated with TJ Maxx and Marshalls, but Ross is like, I would say, Ross is kind of like the Old Navy of the chain. Wow, nice count. Oh my goodness. Oh wow, just enough energy. Jeez, wow. What a comeback there. You can never show your parents this channel. Well, D-Spec, let me know ahead of time. If your parents want to see this channel, I will remove the command. I'll remove the command for them. For one night only. Bad enough, dining room tables and the chairs that go with it are rather expensive. I mean, you want to have something that lasts a long time and looks good. And then you look at the price, you're like, holy snike. I mean, chairs, dining room chairs cost almost $200 a piece. You literally have to buy them in bundles to save a little something. They might knock off $20 a chair if you buy 8 chairs or something like that. 10 chairs. But still, that's a lot. Get vintage, stuff made now is garbage, especially the expensive stuff, yeah. Everything is vulgar. FB Marketplace time, yeah. We've had limited success with FB Marketplace, honestly. I remember when we were still living in Michigan, we did just a couple of FB Marketplace stuff, and I don't know, it was just kind of weird. I think Nikki wasn't really, you know, getting a good vibe on it, so we just kind of stopped doing that. We go to Goodwill, but we don't really buy too much furniture at Goodwill. By the way, Goodwill is crazy out here. We don't really see many Salvation Armies. Like, unlike in the Midwest, when Salvation Army is more prevalent. Yeah, open floor plan is nice. Shinigami here, just keeping away. You can see that throwing out some back fours, four threes.
Fight.
Trying to keep land out of his personal space. I told Nikki, like, you know, when we were searching for a home here, all I wanted was one of the two-car garage. I wanted to have a nice sink with a big island, counter, you know, island, big sink. And then what else did I want? Solar was a plus. And a decent shower, so. And this place that we're in right now fulfilled all of that criteria. Alright, we got Montel Chilius from here. Appreciate you coming through. Yeah, Senpai, honestly, this home that we're in is probably my most favorite home that I've ever been able to own. A good amount of space. It's a one floor, so you don't have to climb upstairs and have to deal with, you know, carting up furniture up and down stairs. So as I get older, I don't have to worry about, you know, hurting my knees on that. The living room is really nice. We call it the great room. I was like, I never ever called a living room the great room. They call it the great room. And our guest room here, they call it a mother-in-law suite, which, you know, it's kind of a tacky term for it, but basically has a bathroom attached to the room. So. What is Mercari? Mercari is a kind of like eBay C16. It's just a place where people can sell and buy things. Just another marketplace.
Annie? Are you walking, Annie?
I personally like Mercari.
Round one.
eBay, man. I know they kind of suck out a lot of fees, and it's just I've been actually doing more stuff on Mercari. And it's very easy. But yeah, the one thing I really I'm quite overjoyed with here is the solar. So this home came with solar, and it's been a great help. When it's nice and sunny, then a lot of times we end up making more electricity and pumping it back in the grid than we are using it that day. And sometimes some months we end up getting paid. Like, we get like a credit from the electric company.
Fight.
Last year, they ended up giving us back like 40 some bucks or something like that, because we didn't, you know, use as much electricity. Literally pays for itself. And I know you guys are probably spending a lot on electricity, because I know I used to live in Michigan and dealt with the high electric fees there, but here,
round three,
you know, pennies with the solar. Or they give you money. Yeah, it's a ridiculous invite. I'm like, you know, that's probably like the one utility I don't even have to worry about. Only in the summertime does it get a little crazy, but even then, with solar, like, with even if you're pumping in a lot of AC just to cool down the home, it's not that bad. My brother, younger brother, you know, he has a home that does not have solar, and he says he pays about $300 to $400 a month in electricity just to cool down their home with the AC and all that during the summertime. $300 to $400, that's a lot. Whereas for us here, I believe when we got the home and we turned on the electricity, or at least put it in our names, we're only paying for about like anywhere like maybe $90. So, you know, $300 to $400 versus $90, it's a nice. And like I said, in the wintertime, rarely have to use it.
KO. You win.
Be careful what you do.
Be careful what you do, Shinigami said. You gotta be careful what you do. Yeah. Now, of course, if you can buy a home that has solar and it's been paid, which the previous owners of this home did, they bought the solar and they paid for it already. Like, there is no loan or lease or anything like that. If you get people like that...
Yo, goddamn spring kicks!
Yeah, you have owners that pay for it already in full, then you're good. Right? The only thing that you need to do is pay a transfer fee. And that's it. Just transfer the services over to your name and you're good. Everything else is good. And our previous owners, the sellers, they actually paid for that transfer fee too. So it was even better. I mean, it was like a $500 transfer fee or something like that to get things in their name and other things like that. But they were very nice and couldn't be any more grateful. We got a good deal on this home. When I build a house, solar panels is a must. Yes, definitely agree. Put your investment in it, you know, get a solar panels. And then the one thing that we do not have with this home is like batteries to store the energy in case there's an outage, which we don't feel like a need to do that at this time. If you want to invest in that later, then you know, we can get the solar energy company to install batteries, but we don't need that right now. Mr. Pockets, how's it going? Good to see you in the chat. How are you doing this evening? Wow, good step. Oh my goodness, GC16. I've never seen. Is that a bat? Oh my. Y16. Oh my. What the heck is C16 doing? Does Arizona even have weather hazards? They do have, you know, extreme heat. That's number one. They also have dust storms. Dust storms where it kind of looks like fog, but it's just a lot of dust flying towards you. It's kind of like, you ever see like some of those movies where you kind of see that like large cloud and it's kind of like an apocalyptic cloud? You kind of get those in Arizona. We have not seen one yet because it hasn't been that time of year. And also Arizona, surprisingly, we can't get floods. Because some of the pathways, you know, there isn't any way for the water to get out sometimes. So some of the monsoon seasons, as they call them, can have a lot of rain and you can get some floods. But we have not experienced that too much here. It's usually on the roads you gotta be careful of if there's no drainage. But it's not, you know, it's not bad. It's not like tornadoes or hurricanes, earthquakes. We don't have any of that here.
Fight.
That's good. I think Shinigami's kind of mad here. He got like thrown twice like that. Shinigami's mad. Does that actually hit grounded? That while saying 3-3? Or was it because C16 was getting up? It looked like, you know, Shinigami was trying to get C16 to move, but I don't know if that while saying 3 actually hit grounded. First hit hits grounded. Oh, nice. Well, there you go. I was like, man, that's actually a pretty nice trick that you can definitely tell a Lee specialist. So, Mr. Pockets, have you experienced any snow tonight? I know supposedly there's some significant snowfall this evening for my fellow Michigan members, but I have not seen any or heard any. The grab was sick. You had to see it again. I was like, Shinigami was like, okay, let's just sidestep me again. I really want to see that throw. Okay. Chiropractic session. Alright, so Senpai relax here with the TGO Nina. I'm definitely going to try to get TGO with Marduk. I think it's time. I've been really working on trying to get more acclimated with the character and work on my block punishment, etc. So I really want to get that going. But I still need to get Jack and Geese up in Tekken God Prime too. That's been kind of on the back burner. I do want to try to play with Katarina though. Katarina's has slept on, so I do need to check her out for a little bit. But definitely work on my mains. I got some time next week because this weekend I'm going to be packed, so no Tekken for me this weekend. Nice low parry. Not yet, supposed to be sleep by tomorrow morning? Okay. Gosh. Sleep is even worse. Gotcha. Okay, that's good to hear, Montel. That's good to hear. One of my best friends actually lives in Massachusetts.
Round two. Fight.
Oh, nice catch. I've always wanted to check out the Boston scene in terms of Tekken, but never got a chance to. Look at the pressure here. This is a prime example of learning how to deal with aggressive nature of his character. I'm not like that. I'm still kind of very passive with Nina, but. Or Senpai Relax knows all the tips and tricks with this character. Nice, match 4. Didn't commit. Oh my, look at the damage off of that. Wow, the jump over? Oh my goodness, Shinigami.
Fight.
Honestly, why are all the blondes in this game do so much damage? Paul Phoenix, Lucky Chloe, Nina Williams. Maybe Bob does more a lot of damage too. I don't know. I think that's like a common theme. Low key have been looking at Nina. Well, definitely can look at her in Tekken 8 because she's gonna be there.
KO.
And what's going on, Azure? Good to see you in the chat.
Round 4.
Bob has that BS unscaled. Yeah, see, there you go. So I just said that all the blondes in this game have extra damage. They're very strong. Throw my Nina with her rage drive was taking a lot of damage. Lucky Chloe, the guy whose name starts with a P. What other blondes are in this game? Oh yeah, I guess you can. I don't know if you would consider Jack as a blonde because of his mohawk.
KO. You win.
Man, good games too. Senpai, bedtime? Relax. Dang, is it past your bedtime? But how have you been, Azure? Hopefully all is well with you. Has work been really busy for you? Yeah, You know, I'm actually looking forward to checking out Evo Japan. Looking forward to when it's, I think it starts at the end of March sometime then. And I really wait to see some of the closed alpha test footage. Hopefully they'll allow people to release it, unless they have to sign some type of NDA where you can't. They'll basically allow you to test behind curtains. No pictures, no photos. But I don't know. We'll see if they allow you to kind of release media, upload videos on YouTube. Work is busy, but some duties change and you work less hours as of last. Oh, nice. Okay. I guess that is a good thing. Working less is good. As long as you, don't make less. I know a lot of people, they're hourly, and of course that kind of cuts into their wages, but if you're salaried, then working less is always the goal. Except I relax here with the Lucky Chloe Tekken God Prime. Oh my goodness. Round two. Fight. Hey, look at this. This outfit's not too bad. Azure, I'm surprised you don't have this cosplay from Senpai Relax. This is actually not too bad here. Nice duck. Oh, drop combo. Wow, nice. Nice carry. Oh, trying to go for the ender here. Lan is getting really used to the the back one there. Oh, and the Keech? Fight. Okay, Lan. Getting a little spicy here. Somebody's got to be taking their end acid. You want to be getting ulcers from all the spices. You're stealing in that? It's actually pretty nice. Oh my goodness, look at the counter hits from Lan though. Lan needs to call himself Ethernet. Oh yeah, I'll be changing my name to Ethernet now. You know how a lot of round four Korean players have some fight weird gamer tags. Mine will be Ethernet. Cat 6. Shielded. He held up after a counter hit while standing too. Of course, yes. He found it a good opportunity to hold up. Nice counter. There's Lan. Yeah, I know, right? Yeah, that's the Lan that I'm thinking about, Azure. But we got ourselves an American Lan. Whatever you do. Oh, nice counter! Oh, counter. The serving tray. The back one. That was close. That was not bad, Lan. Not bad at all. Very good stuff. Ethernet. Wait, Ether? I call back one Chloe the serving tray. I love it. I wish Lan would have capitalized the L in his Twitch name, because every time I look at that, I want to say it's Ian, but it's not. It's Lan. So I made the first mistake when I first saw him. Like, oh hey Ian, I mean Lan. I've heard of Ether. But I don't know, what context you speak of. Oh, Ian is actually your actual name? Oh, I didn't know that. Dang. I thought, okay. So Ian is your name. Oh, geez. I was confused all this time. So it's Ian, real name Ian, but Round Lan one. Is his gamer team. Oh my goodness. That's a joke? Okay, gotcha. But, D-Spec. I don't know Ether the song. No, I do not. I know Ether as in, like, the chemical. But I don't know Ether as in the song. Alyssa's another one of those interesting characters. Chainsaw is for sure. I had a really difficult time against an Alyssa as I was climbing rank of Ether. I was doing really well. No issues with the, you know, from Fujin and Ryujin, and then I ran into an Emperor Alyssa. I was just going back and forth like no other. I'm like, oh my god, I don't run into this character that often. Then I'm getting bopped by Alyssa with her chainsaws, cutting up my bat. So the one thing I realized against Negan, or with Negan, any character with 13 frame range arts are they get a special bonus if you can goes for down back two. So if Negan goes for down back two, and if the opponent is in rage or puts them in rage in some form, and the opponent's character has a 13 frame rage arc, guess what? Negan dies. Negan cannot block the rage arc. Cannot transition out of intimidation stance fast enough.
Round four. Fight.
Oh, Ether is a song by Nas where he dissed Jay-Z significantly. Not golden. Okay. I'll have to check it out. But yeah, that's your little tip, folks. For those of you who have a 13 frame rage art and playing against Negan, if for some reason they're gonna go for a down back two and they put you in rage, or if you're in rage and you're still alive, activate the rage art. They cannot block it. They cannot. That is hilarious. It is. The regular rage art speed is fine. He can transition out in time, but cannot get out of any rage art by transitioning out of intimidation in time. He can't. And that's what that Alyssa discovered. The Alyssa player I ran into actually liked to throw out rage arts anyways. But that was the one thing that I couldn't wrap my head around. I'm like, why am I getting hit by this? I'm transitioning out, right? I went to practice mode and I was like, wait a second, I cannot block. I'm like, okay, I'm not doing this move at all when the opponent's in rage. That's like one off limits move.
Get ready for the next battle.
So characters like Jin, Steve, Anna, Alyssa. I think that's all the characters that have a 13 frame range.
Round one. Fight.
Alright, Senpai relax here with the AK. You're gonna learn Jin and never block that low ever again. Especially in rage. Okay, lightning screws. You'll always get hit by one, especially when you're playing against C16. I got hit by two of them. He's there to make a statement. That's hot. Throwing them bodies.
KO. Round two. Fight.
That's alright. Yep, you gotta get hit by it. Exactly. Yep. Just get them conditioned. And then, you know, I was desperate to try to do some damage because they weren't blocking low. And, you know, so many, I can get only so many down back fours or down fours. So I was like, let me go for a beefy low. Down back two. I'm dead. stacks when low. C16 trying to stay. Oh, almost had the conversion there. Just up axes.
Okay,
down 4-1. Okay. Okay.
Round 3.
I think it's really nice that they actually gave Armor King a nice homing mid there. Similar to Kazuya's down 4-2. Spring kick. Nice running 3. Oh, here we go. Chain. Going for the simple one. I believe that's a 1-3. Oh. Nice one by Senpai. Good games to C16 as well. Oh, you can he has no weakness as a character? Okay. He's a dummy character. Alright, well thank you so much C16 for coming through and getting some games in with us. Really appreciate your time. Now let's see if we can check and see who else might be online. Let's see, did anybody else sign up on the list here? Okay, I think we're all taken care of here. So next, next, and next. And by the way, folks, for those of you who just came in, we do have some new commands or new sounds that I recently posted. So I actually made a new sounds command so that way you can filter through the entire library of sounds that I have listed. Instead, I just put the list of the new sounds I made so that way you can check them out at your leisure. So those are some new sounds. Of course, Rodney D-Towns King had asked me to throw in some Tekken 8 Nina quotes, so I did that, and of course we have a new sound here for Azure.
Azure, what's your plus two?
Round 1.
8. Wait, 4. 4. Wait, 4. 4.
Oh man. No, I think Sensei Blaze had. I think the topic was about math, right? And then Sensei Blaze had asked Azure what 2 plus 2 was.
Round 2.
I think there was some insinuation that as a Lucky Chloe player, you're good at math to be able to count them. And then Sensei Blaze was kind of blurred out there. I think that was the. You know, what was being talked about. We finally made it, yes. But hey, Jenny got me here. Doing pretty nicely against Senpai's Fujimitsu. Nice. Down back 3.
Round 3.
Yeah, these are, it was a confidence thing. Azure, yeah, I know this answer. Azure was thinking about 2 to the 3rd power. But, 2 plus 2 was the question. Oh, doesn't get the full combo there. Full strength. Good break. Okay,
KO.
And then low.
Round 4.
That is a common fight. Round ender. Cat 4. Wow, nice power crush. Wow, good little parry there by Senpai. Going to the wall. Nice. Good mix. Trying to delay the string there to catch a counter hit. Actually, is that string the second hit and then the third hit's guaranteed? Is that a normal hit or is it only a counter hit? That I forget. Oh my good. Whoa, what? What was that? Oh, that was a trade?
KO.
Oh my goodness, that was a crazy trade. Guaranteed uncountering? Okay. Fight. Thank you, Azure. figured that was the reason why Senpai was trying to slow it down there. Like, I blinked for a second, and I'm like, what the heck happened with that range drive? And I looked over the Twitch stream, and I saw it. Oh, wait, they tried. Nice. Nice count. Onto the slide. Oh, and the spring kick?
You've been hit You've been hit by a smooth criminal.
You've been hit by a smooth criminal.
Watch! Yo, goddamn! Spring kicks!
Who else would like to join in here in the fun? Montel, I appreciate you coming through and getting some games in with us.
Watch! Yo, goddamn! Spring kicks!
Let's see. I don't see anybody else here who maybe a student that would like to join in.
Die in silence.
Get ready for the next battle.
Okay, sounds good, Azure. Yeah,
die in silence.
Feel free to join in here. Oh my god, Ian Lance as Paul.
Just show your face.
What do I think about the Jin trailer? I think it's awesome. Mr. Pockets, again, really like, really liking how Jin's got some new strings, and of course, adding to the Devil Jin flair. Again, I mentioned that he's now part of the Fin It Down 2 club. That was the first move that he threw out in the trailer, Fin It Down 2. And Sako, what is going on? Where have you been? And first of all, thank you so much for coming through. And second, hopefully you've been well. And yes, I am waiting for that Jack trailer. I'm about to pop off as soon as I see that trailer. I hope that trailer is next week. But I'm glad they're kind of releasing these one at a time. I want to see Jack.
Round two.
I have a feeling that we're not going to see Jack until a little bit later, but that's okay. I'm just happy to see somebody. Soon Driver says, hoping for two a month? Okay. One character week. Yeah, I like the one character week too. It kind of reminds me of way back in the day when arcade versions were a thing. We have time release characters. And Spartan Chino, thank you so much for the raid. Party of 15. Thank you so much, Spartan Chino. Hopefully you had a wonderful stream.
And
I know he's also been hosting a number of first and tens. I think doing the Florida versus Boston thing, or maybe some other regions. But thank you so much, Barchi. Sokka's still playing Magic the Gathering. How do you like that game so far? Are you doing any more ping pong, or did you give that up for Magic? And Ruthless Retta, not any Lee, but we got Michael Jackson Lee here. MJ Chawan. You can call him Lee Jackson or Michael Chow Long, what do you want to call him?
KO.
Lab Wolf, you had lost me completely after saying that. I'll play some Shinigami here.
Welcome to the King of Iron Fist Tournament 7. Craig Marduk.
Play Panda. It's been fun. Play ping pong, okay. Went 0-5, but you learned a lot. Good. Ping pong is the brand name, and that's really named table tennis.
Ready for the next battle.
I just thought table tennis was another name. Yeah, I thought so too. I thought ping pong was actually also table tennis, but it's kind of like cotton swabs and Q-tips, right? Can I have a Q-tip? We all know what Q-tip is, right? But it's actually a cotton swab. Q-tip is the brand. So things like that. That's actually fun. I did not know that ping pong was actually a brand name.
Get your cameras ready, folks.
Round one. Fight.
Wow. I counter.
KO. Round two. Fight.
Dang.
KO. Round three. Fight. Nice stuff, Shinigami. Nice stuff. Kept whipping my down back too. I'm like, this guy is just outside my range. Brand so powerful they take over our language, yeah. Like Band-Aid too, right? Band-Aid could be bandage. Band-Aid is the term or the brand of the bandages. Kleenex and tissues. Yeah, that's another one from LAN. Like icebox and refrigerator. That one I did not hear of. Popsicles is the brand name? It is? Oh my goodness, I've been deceived. Fight.
Ice pops are what they, oh my goodness. That's crazy. I did not know that. There's a point where you're calling every cleaning solution Chine Salt? Oh my goodness. It's like somebody grab a Chine Salt. You mean clean for the clean windows? Yeah. That blue spray Chine Salt. I call the glass cleaner, I call them Windex, you know, thing.
Round two, fight.
Nice, good hop, hop kick, excuse me. Vice Grip is a brand of locking pliers. I always thought Vice Grips was just a type. Yeah, that's great. Yeah. low parry. Boom, 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 boom.
KO. Round 3. Fight.
Katarina is another one of those characters that need to be careful how to press. And we got a decent hop kick too. Got the hop kick, got a little nerf, but now it's still effective. Downward one is actually pretty good. Ooh, that's a delay and a strength.
KO. Round 4.
Down south, people fight. Call every soft drink a Coke. Dang. What if you request a Pepsi? They look at you funny and... But you gotta have a Coke. And also in the south too, I know that the assumption if you want iced tea is always sweetened unless you specify unsweetened. You know, kind of like a default. Whereas around up in the Midwest or in other regions, unsweet iced tea is the default. You gotta request for sweet tea. Cold Pepsi. Yeah, I kind of wonder that myself. Bull crouch down 4-4. Katarina is actually pretty scary. Against some characters that do have good punishment for her lows, it's not too bad, but she's still a threat. Oh, yeah, Katarina's a walking hour violation. What? I'm sorry, Ian. Could you repeat? A walking what? A walking HR violation. Oh, HR violation. Okay. I'm sorry, like abbreviating hour. Walking HR violation. Okay. If you had capitalized HR, I would have understood, but lowercase, I'm like, tower? Jet Ski's a brand name too? Okay. I guess we're all in the topic. Let's look at brand names that we call generic products. Crockpot. Bubble wrap. Onesie. Jacuzzi. Breathalyzer.
Fight.
What in the world? Chapstick. That's one. Yeah, I know. I keep saying that. Rollerblades. Scotch tape. Sharpie. Tupperware. Velcro. Whiteout. Oh my goodness.
KO.
Exacto knife.
Round
dumpster.
Two. Fight.
Xerox. Plexiglass, styrofoam, PowerPoint, Google. Man. I looked online. I Googled it.
Round 3. Fight.
Somebody relax here with the Josie. Student Death here. Student Death has also played as Josie in some respects. But now looking to work on the thing.
KO.
You about to break my brain? Oh my goodness.
Fight.
Help. Mouth breathing density calculator, aka breathalyzer. Breathalyzer, let's see.
KO.
I can't believe-
Yes, yeah, so Breathalyzer is owned by the Indiana University Foundation. They used to originally call it the Drunkometer. But yeah, the name is patented, and then now it's called Breathalyzer. Any noun can be a verb if you noun hard enough. Of course. Like Google, for example. Google it. The sound of an apparatus that sounds smart, yeah. That's a good one. Like if you want to use water, you know, water is technically a noun, but you say, you know, water me down. Or hose, right? Hose is a noun. Hose me down. Even if you're wrong, double down. Round one. You'll convince enough people to be right. Fight. Something relaxing with the Julia Chen. Mix. The hell sweep. No punish on the wall standing one. Minus 13.
Perfect.
Nice. New move, is it like a
round two?
4-4-4 or something like that? Oh, spring kick. Nice. Lashing arrow. Apparatus is on my list of words I like. Apparatus, yeah.
Round three, fight.
That's what scuba stands, right? Like scuba? Self-contained underwater breathing apparatus? Scuba. That's what whoever wanted to create that acronym, scuba. Yeah. Look, yeah, scuba. Self-contained underwater breathing apparatus. Scuba. That's what it means. Yes, D-Spec, that's what it means. Nice, good rage up. Rage drive. See?
KO. You win.
Stream.
Sakos, and now look up laser. Laser stands for light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation. Dang, that's a lot. You're right, Sako. It is another one.
Welcome to the King of Iron Fist Tournament 7. Negan.
Light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation.
Ready for the next battle.
Put the Neener. I like Senpai Relax's Neena. Very aggressive, offense oriented. I have to watch what I do.
Going somewhere?
Yes! I got an RV, baby. We're going somewhere.
Round one.
Where you want to go?
Fight.
Nice. Oh, good comedy.
KO. Round 2. Fight.
Oh, nice counter. I go for upward 4, got counter hit by her upward 4.
KO.
Oh, nice. Good pressure.
Round 3. Fight. KO. Round 4.
What do those leg belts do? Fight. No idea. Oh my goodness, look at the wall pounce. Nice stuff.
KO.
Look at the wall bounce.
Final round. Fight.
Oh, good counter. Try to go for a little second attack.
Not cool.
Good job.
KO.
Nice. Good stuff, Senpai.
You lose.
Alright, Sako, thank you so much for coming through. I really appreciate you stopping by and chilling with us for a little bit. Yes, and please do, Sako. Come on through and say hello. I'll send Azure here an invite. Get some games in. So the driver says for guns and bullets and stuff. Alright, now we got ourselves a nice party. I just opened this up on Facebook. This person says, Michael B. Jordan is cute, but doesn't have any edge. He just look, I don't know, responsible. He looked like he know where his birth certificate at. Oh my goodness. He know where his birth certificate at. He know, he looked like he know where his birth certificate at. Oh my goodness.
Time to die. Just show your face.
Round 1.
Did Asher join the lobby? Yes, he did. Oh my goodness. That's what I'm gonna say to someone next time. I'm like, sir, you look like you know where your birth certificate is at. You look like someone who, doesn't evade from the IRS. This cosplay kind of reminds me of Mystique. Now, if only Senpai Relax were to change the hair color to the orange color? Or red? I don't know what color Mystique's hair is. Yeah, you can kind of make this a Mystique cosplay. That's hell of a compliment, I know, right? You look like you know where your birth certificate is at. No, I appreciate you, Steven Driver. Yeah, for sure. Stick around and try to get as much as you can out of this session. You look like you iron your own clothes. Oh my goodness. Wow.
Round 3. Fight.
Slow-mo is here. Oh, the trade. Wow, Senpai was able to get a follow-up after that. I mean, can't you get a copy of your birth certificate somewhere? Like, if you lost it? I'm just saying, you know, if you don't know where it is, you can always get a copy somewhere, right? I guess that would require advanced knowledge too, so you'd be like, he looked like someone who would know where to find his birth certificate. Oh, nice counter. Yeah, you can always get a copy, right? I'm just thinking. Oh wow, nice float there by Shinigami. Wow, nice range drive.
KO.
Okay, I always gotta go for that spring kick.
Final round.
Can't get out of it, but might as well try.
Fight.
Counter. Wow. Small punish on that. Minus 13 on Hitman 2 though. Good block on the slide. Senpai tried to go for a counter hit trap there. Nice string. Just wipe the floor. That's still hard to block for me. Nice tech. And now we got tenacity here. Oh, nice string. That was close. I know Shinigami was looking for an opening. Went for the sway back into Acid Storm, and Senpai was not biting. That was good. That was really good. Late low parry. No, that was very close. Look like someone that keeps a budget spreadsheet because I am. You and I too, Azure. I know I have been budgeting, you know, using Excel to keep my spreadsheets and expenses and all that stuff since I moved to Michigan. Because I realized that I was, when I first moved here, I had little to no idea as to what I was spending my money on. And then I was like, I got to figure out, you know, where this is going. So, and to this day, I have been keeping a budget and on my spreadsheets.
Round 1. Fight.
Senpai relies with the knockers.
KO.
Nice down.
Round 2. Fight.
Can't wait to play this character tonight and never play them again. Oh my goodness, Azure just throwing out the tidbits here.
KO. Round 3. Fight.
Hey, down back 1-2 there by Student Driver. Wow, here we go. Nice step. Oh, doesn't get the max punish on that.
Perfect. Wow.
Back tempo step 1.
Round 4. Fight.
Wow, nice parry. Oh, doesn't get the dash. Nice, yep. Senpai saw that last time when Student Driver attacked after that spring. Counter hit, nice. Ooh. Spring kick to get up and the sidestep, down back 1. Very nice. What? No, I'm not overselling it. It's amazing. Fingers froze up when you hit the hop kick. No worries. Yeah, you had the nice Tsubaki there with the 1+2. That was a good read. Yeah, it's all good, Student Driver. I think, you know, if you have an opportunity to land the launcher, then try to make the most of it. Even if you lose, that's fine. You know, you still get a point for maximizing your combo, your damage as you can.
Get ready for the next battle.
Every time you see Noctis, you want to play Final Fantasy 15? Dang. Marketing is working.
Fight.
Except I realize with the Miguel. And of course, land here with the deer head. Doe head, actually. This is a doe. No antlers. Didn't they say that Final Fantasy 16 was not going to be on PC or something like that? It was just going to be a PlayStation exclusive? I'm surprised that they're not looking at the PC version.
Round 2.
Which
fight?
Which Final Fantasy 16 character? I'm going to pray none of them. It'll be interesting to see what new characters they develop in Tekken, you know. I am curious what I'm doing. I know it's gonna blow people's minds too. I think the one funny thing was when Negan came out, they're like, something like, some people didn't know who the heck this character was because they never watched The Walking Dead. They're like, oh, who's this guy? At least everybody else kind of knew, whether from previous Tekken or...
Round 3.
The new characters, fight. You know, just fine. Guest characters, you kind of like, who is that? And we know that Miguel's got a nice, fast back one as well, 11 frame back one. That rivals Armor King's back one, which is 12 frame. Bang.
You win.
Imagine Cammy from Street Fighter 6 comes in as a Williams sister. Rival from boarding school. Dang. That would be crazy. Alright, Lan. Well, thank you so much for coming through and getting some games in with us.
Welcome
we appreciate
to
your
the
time.
King of Iron Fist Tournament 7. Craig Marduk.
Practice some more. Good stuff, Lan. Good stuff. Thank you for your time, as always. Appreciate you sticking in through time to play. Let's see. Do have one more spot now.
Get ready for
might stick with this location for a little bit. Anybody else is down who's in the chat who wants to play, let me know. We can get you in.
Come over here.
Get your cameras ready, folks.
Round one.
Fight. Marduk always gets what he wants. Yeah.
KO.
Get mixed.
Round two. Fight. KO. Round three. Fight.
Nice step. Oh my goodness, nice. I'm dead. Boom, boom.
Nice. KO.
Good stuff, Senpai. Good stuff.
You lose.
I tried to force my way through and go for an actual BTS mix. It did not work. Good stuff. What is this Skeletor mask? A scary mask. I don't know if it's a mod or something, but it worked. I like it on random outfits. It's a very good lobby here. Lots of good practice. Strong opponents, strong training partners. Surprisingly, it doesn't not fit.
Round one. Fight.
It's kind of like she's a witch or something, you know? Oh my god, Azure with the Lee Chao Long? The project he's been working on, the Lee Chao Long. Nice counter. Oh, drop combo.
KO. Round two. Fight.
The MJ Chao Long. Nice magic core. Okay, oh. Chukka. Chukka. Oh. Nice. Nice low parry. Go for the slide.
KO.
And down back three, nice.
Round three. Fight.
Counter. Chukka. Oh, good spin. Wow, the flip. Slidey. Oh, nice low pair there. Azure trying to go for the empty jump into the low. Oh, gets caught. That flip. Panda is my hero.
Fight.
This is great. I would not expect Azure to play with me, but here we are. Nice counter. Delay.
You win.
My pleasure.
That's a scary ass Anna. Time to die again. So good.
My pleasure.
Death has been delayed, yes. Shinigami is gonna show you. Let me show you the real Lee here. I'm the Lee Chaolan of Michigan.
Get ready for the next battle.
I hate this character.
Round one. Fight.
Oh, separate like with the Asuka.
KO.
And down 4-4.
Round 2. Fight.
Oh, wow, stand. Oh, whoa. Doesn't get to the launcher, but lots of damage still. Going downstairs. Nice punish. Counter. Wow, the magic board. Wow, good low parry by Senpai. What we got? Oh, wow, good backdash. Backdash the infinite kicks into down 4-4, right? Yeah, that's a really good learning tool, Azure, right? I mean, that's sometimes I play characters just to see how people deal with them.
Perfect.
So that's a good one. And Student Driver, it really is just lots of practice, right? I mean, once you have a good, solid fundamental of how to play Tekken, then you can apply that to any character. And then it's just a matter of learning the character's moves and combos. You kind of know how to play the game, so you just gotta know some of the specifics of the character. And that's it. And you don't have to know everything about the character, just to, you know, be able to play them proficiently. You want to maximize stuff? Yeah, definitely want to explore more time into the character and learn max combos and situations. But if you're looking to play, then not that difficult after you practice a few combos. In other words, just more time, more patience. Yep. And that's the key. Man, good stuff, Senpai Relax. Really retaining a very good win streak tonight. Good training as always. Anybody looking to watch Creed 3? I think that's coming out tonight. This Friday, right? Tomorrow? Anybody watching that? Anybody watch the Creed series?
Get ready for the next battle.
You hear things, good things, yeah. You had a big crush on Tessa Thompson, all right?
Fight.
Creed 3, y'all said, yeah. It's coming out, I think, tomorrow in theaters.
KO. Round 2. Fight.
That Shinigami here with the Jin Kaza. Her Donna's finally got more in-depth story instead of Rocky guiding. Yeah, that's cool. Yeah, it's good that Rocky is kind of out of the series now. I think it's good that he's finally doing his own thing. Michael B. Jordan is the director? Okay, nice. I love how actors get the chance to direct movies too. It's really cool.
KO. Round 3. Fight.
Oh my goodness. Kip up. I believe the kip up is actually safe. I don't think it's punchable if you block it. You're gonna have to whip punch instead. Niners are too responsible. Yeah, no, the guy knows his knows where his birth certificate's at. All actors secretly want to be directors at a certain point. Yeah, that sounds good.
KO.
I can see that.
Round 4. Fight.
Counter hit. Oh, nope. Magic 4 on counter hit with Bang, you can get a free shoulder in certain victories. Steam driver. Oh, nice. Good back one. And how's it going, Energy Martyr? Good to see you in the chat. Appreciate you stopping by. How are you? Super excited for Scream 6. Scream is a series that I have not been keeping up. So I definitely need to watch some. I actually don't recall much of the series. So I want to do a refresh. No, Energy Marduk. Speaking of Marduk, Energy Marduk. I have been learning Marduk, so any advice you may have with the character, please share with me. It's been about, I would say about a month and some change with the character, so still growing.
You win.
New Scream is basically a parody of itself now, and not a bad thing. Okay, gotcha. Tracking is killing you. Yeah, I guess pressure, right? Mix-ups, I think I kind of understand. I think the one thing I'm also having issues with is learning how to deal with pressure on against some opponents.
Welcome
but then
to the King of
dealing
Iron
pressure
Fist
is also
Tournament
good too.
7. Craig Marduk.
Now, the one thing I'm trying to do right now is avoid using tackle, because I know that's a that's something I can throw out there anytime I want to, or I'm trying to learn how to play this character, or I would say improve my fundamentals with this character. And that's one thing I'm kind of not consistent with, is my fundamentals. And that could be me generally as a player too. So.
Round one. Fight.
Hey Kay, how's it going? Good to see you in the chat. Play all as well. Hop. Back one.
Round two. Fight.
Down 4-4 for poking. Down 3. Of course, 4-2. Okay. Oops. Oh, nice launch. Nice. All right, student dead. Good stuff.
Round three. Fight. Perfect. Round four. Fight. KO.
More down back to you.
Final right. Round. Fight.
Alright, nice pressure, certain victory. Nice pressure. One. Trying to work on my defense too. Trying not to challenge too much, but sometimes I feel like it's a need. Alright, good stuff, certain student driver. Thank you so much.
Welcome to the King, Craig Marduk.
Kunimitsu was C tier in Tekken Tag 2. Oh man. You know, for a game that has been... I don't know how the online was on PlayStation, but I have a feeling that the PC version of Tekken Tag 2 with the online built into it, I think that's probably better.
Get ready for the next.
I know we're expecting a lot based on what we're experiencing now with Tekken 7, but... I think it's come a long way. If now, if they get Tekken 6 online, and the online is... I mean, that online was terrible. If you want to play Tekken 6 online on PlayStation 3, that was so bad. Really bad. Tekken has come a long way. Round one. You're learning Fang too? Oh my goodness, energy martyr. I call you energy Fang. Calling Mama Fini Dotan. Oh no, help. Sorry, that's me. PC is going nuts. Oh, good count. Wow, that still works. Oops. KO. Oh, nice power crush.
Round 4. Fight.
Nice Alright, good stuff, Azure. Nicely. Sorry for the frame drops earlier. Not sure what happened to my CPU. Watching Azure play Lee is funny because he's not enjoying the neutral. Alright, student King driver, well, thank Iron you so Fist much for spending some time with us tonight. I really appreciate you coming through and getting some games with us. Ethism, thank you so much for coming through as well and keeping us company. Have a wonderful evening, both of you. Thank you. Keep up the good work. And of course, definitely reach out if you have any questions about Fang. I know we have a number of resources that are good with that character, so don't be afraid to ask questions. Of course, if you want us to critique any matches that you have, feel free to put it in the match review channel. I think that's the one channel that has been underutilized, is people just posting some matches and getting some feedback. I think that'd be helpful, goes a long way. Don't worry, student driver, one of these days you'll be doing all the whooping.
This ain't gonna last long.
You'll be whooping us as well. We'll keep up the work. Oops.
Perfect.
Yeah. I need to work on round two. Learning how to deal with pressure. Fight. Nice counter. Maybe I shouldn't be too aggressive myself. Nice step. Sorry, my bad. I freaked out on the combo there.
KO. Nice. Round 3. fight. KO.
Also, going cold doesn't help. Muscle memory still isn't there. Yeah, I understand.
KO. Final round. Fight.
Oh, nice counter. Oh.
Oh.
Nice one, Senpai. Nice one. I get lost when I get when I can't take my turn. I think I get lost with this character too. Good stuff. Good stuff. I'll definitely need to work on getting some more games with the against the Cat Arena too. Tag 2 is hard. See? I like when players who are playing are starting off with Tekken 7. Then they go back to play something like Tag 2. It's an eye-opener, right? I mean, granted, you have to play with two characters and then you have combos with the tag system and all that. Try to play the game solo. And I think the game is a little different. You actually have to break the normal throws as one or two. I think that's number one. And then I think, isn't there like some rollback text and stuff like that too? Tekken 6 was about the same.
Round one.
Yeah, Tekken 6 is hard too.
Fight.
I think that, you know, there's a lot of mechanics in this game, Tekken 7, that's you kind of take for granted, and then you go back and play an older game. And it's like, man, this is hard stuff. Yeah. I did like Tekken 6 because back then that game was my shining moment. Then it kind of went downhill from there. You're playing T4 and you forgot how fast throw animations were. I know, right? Oh, Shinigami here. Broken controller. There we go. Kind of wonder how the throw animations are for like the older Tekken 3 games or Tekken Tag. Versace Internet. Got that DI designer internet. Wow, good catch there. Mix.
KO.
Good side roll there by Shinigami.
Round three. Fight.
Nice counter.
Yeah.
Shinigami here. Just being extra careful. Oh my goodness. I was going to say extra careful, and then Senpai with the hop kick. Oh, nice counter. I do like how Senpai was kind of threatening the rage drive there, but instead went to a back turn one. Down back twos. Wow, that evaded the down three, that AOP. Doesn't get the punish on that. Oh, here we go, wall bounce, rage. Oh, no, drops a combo. Oh my goodness! Oh my! Wow!
You win!
Wow! Senpai, did you forget what the rage art was with Ling? I was like, he did the back one. I was like, wait a second. We could probably get a kill with the rage drive, but rage art. Excuse me. Oh, it's back one plus two, but you did back one by mistake. Oh, okay, gotcha. That makes sense. I'm convinced that if you pick random, this game will sometimes pick the same stage against the same player. It's like the bug or something. That's kind of weird, yeah.
Fight.
And Krusty Bullet, thank you so much for the follow. Welcome to the stream. Hopefully having a wonderful evening, Krusty Bullet. Thank you so much for coming through. Oh, nice interrupt there. Rage try.
KO.
Oh.
Round two. Fight.
Hunter, nice back four up there. Wow, nice counter there. One plus two. Honestly, you think that K, but Senpai Relax stated specifically that he sometimes puts the skull on some random costumes. Look at the hood and the skull. He says he sometimes does it randomly, so. He did that with Anna, and he did this with Zafina too. This actually kind of works with Zafina. Not gonna lie. Nice block.
Reactions. Round 3. Fight.
Nice stuff. They're in different colors? Yeah, I know. Senpai can probably mention. Oh, he's hit by Ash or something. Ooh, counter. Nice block. Some down forward ones. Check. Ah, the hop kick. Back one. That's it.
KO. Nice. Round four.
Oh, I thought it was default color? Okay.
Fight.
Okay. Oh, good counter. Wow, nice. Wow, staying 2-3. Oh no, gets caught by the rage drive. He's not dead yet. Oh, right. Nice block. What?
You win.
One too many down fours. That was good though. That was nice. You got a skull on one of your outfits too in the same color as this. Oh, nice. Okay. I recently
Welcome
dressed up my
Marduk. Craig Marduk.
Panda. The hop kick land was a miss input. Ah, okay. Yeah, I was gonna say like Senpai had a good read there, but sealed the deal with a hop kick. Am I a Marduk main now? No, I'm trying to get better with this character. He could be a secondary of mine just because, you know, I know people tend to get pissed off with this character and not learn how to deal with his tackles and the damage. So I was like, okay, this sounds like a good character to try. Jack will still always be my main. I haven't played with Geese in a while though, but I know a lot of people don't feel good about them 2Ds.
This ain't gonna last. Round one.
No, this is, yeah, that's right. I'm gonna lose quick. This is not gonna last. Next step. Nice step.
KO. Round two.
How long will this lobby be open for? Think about probably until 1 o'clock.
Get that bullshit out of here!
Maybe another half an hour or so. Oops, I'm lost anything though. Only my select. No, no!
I will crush you!
We'll probably play for a little bit more than half an hour.
Round three. Fight.
Help.
Great.
All right, good stuff, Senpai. I made a mistake on the wall combo there. I didn't mean to do 1-2. I should have went, you know, maybe 1-2 in the back four or something like that. But I kind of froze up after I messed my input on that.
Welcome to the King of Iron Fist Tournament 7, Craig Marduk.
Oh, this is really good practice. I'm so happy that Azure, Senpai, and Shinigami here in this really small lobby. It's really cool. Nice short rotation. Everybody can get some games quickly. It's been a while since I played all of you too, so it's nice. It's really nice.
Get ready for the next battle.
If I don't win a match though, I'm playing Lee another week. Okay.
Round one. Fight.
Oops. No. Oh, nice one. What? You see that block?
KO.
The block from the back?
Round two.
Somebody clip that, please.
Fight.
No, my combo. Oh no, help.
KO.
I'm not doing enough
Round
BS.
Three. Fight. KO. Round four.
The clip doesn't Fight. Work anymore, unfortunately. The guy who created that command gave up, and then he stopped supporting it, so. Feel bad, though. Oh, good time. Help.
KO.
Good game, Shinigami. That was my bad, Pressman. After down 4-2-3, I should know better, but I get caught up on the press. Yeah, I always wondered that too, Senpai. Like, how do you block? Like, how does that work? And I always wonder too, is it because, you know, maybe we're both playing on 1P and that's kind of messing things up? I was wondering how we can replicate that.
Get ready for the next battle.
And, Hui, how's it going? Hopefully I pronounced that right. Shinigami here with the Fang, Azure with the Lee. That'll be another thing to see one day, Azure playing with Fang.
Your bird is mine.
If I lose Evo to a block
Round
in the
one.
Back, I'm gonna
fight.
Guess who you play? I don't know. I'm pretty bad at guessing. How about you tell us? Who's your main character, Hui? King? Senpai, I'm guessing King? I see a lot of dog emotes here, so kind of wondering. Inquiring minds want to know.
KO. Round two. Fight.
What? Chip Zanuck? What the heck is that? What game is that from? Wow, nice shoulder. Oh my god, the hop meat! I love it.
Round three. Fight.
Well, yeah, I think you're talking to same here, right? Yoshi, Lee, and Raven. Okay. Alright. Not bad. Who's your main character? Yoshi? Oh, we got you know, a number of Lee players here. You know, Azure looking to pick up Lee. Wow, nice launch. Boom, boom. In that order, yeah, okay, cool.
KO.
Down three is a
round four.
Very good low with Bang. Fight. Underestimated for sure. Got good range and sometimes some characters can't do anything about it. While standing three. So Hui, how long have you been playing Tekken for? What's your Tekken history like? Been playing long? Recently started playing? Hee hee. Azure loves the hee hee. That was a nice step there in the back four. April last year? Okay. Got almost a year under your belt here. Just one more month. That's good. How do you like Tekken so far? What got you into playing Tekken? Oh my goodness. 1-3 into shoulder. Man, tried to step on Fang. Alright, no problem, Senpai. Thank you so much for your time tonight. I really, really appreciate the games. Thank you. Let's see. It's made you feel unproductive when you play other games now? Okay. I'm just gonna play him another Wii. You know what, Hui? I was the same way, too. Well, I started playing Tekken and I took a break, or I was actually retired at one point. Played a lot of Call of Duty, and then I came back to playing Tekken, so I kind of get the FPS thing. Enfang says, do not move, only stand. Well, how's it going, Enfang? Good to see you in the chat.
Get ready for the
picked it because shooters are brain dead? Yeah, they could be. I only got as far as really just doing pub stomping. I was not like a pro FPS shooter or anything, so I like to play with some friends and we just go to town. What is this? In-N-Out has the second healthiest fast food cheeseburger in America. What in the world? What am I reading on Facebook here? Oh, by the way, folks, we got plenty of In-N-Out restaurants here. So if you like In-N-Out, you'll like it here. Alright, Kay, well, thank you so much for coming through and keeping us company. Really appreciate you coming through and sharing us how you're doing, and hopefully get to see you again soon, Kay. Thank you so much. Have a wonderful evening. And thank you for the great stream. Amy's Drive-Thru in Santa Rosa.
KO.
Unfortunately, I do not live in California, so I do not have access to Amy's drive-thru. No, we do not have In-N-Out in Michigan. Nope. That is not a thing. Yeah, Steak and Shake for the first time at Frosty. Yeah, I'm not, you know, I think Steak and Shake is okay. It's not like my favorite anything. Yeah, Michigan and certainly Culver's. I mean, we do have Culver's in Arizona too. Culver's kind of a nationwide chain.
KO.
Nice, good pressure here by Senpai.
Round three. Fight.
Counter. Culver's and Sonic. Yeah, I recently had Culver's. I didn't have any of their sandwiches or burgers, but I did have their concrete dessert. Kind of like, it's an equivalent to like a Dairy Queen's Blizzard or something like that. But I do like Dairy Queen's Blizzard much better, to be honest. But anyway, I had one of those concrete desserts, and they were not bad.
KO.
Honestly, I have not been to Sonic's in a while, so I need to check them out. White Castle, Pearl. Oh my god, I have not had White Castle in a long time. Arizona, we have a place called Freddy's Steak Burgers, so they're kind of like flattened patties. Pretty good. Spit. Oh, the key chart! Oh my goodness. I'm in Arizona now, anything, yes.
KO.
There we go, now we got the you proper key. Win. Good stuff. Good games to Senpai, and good games to Shinigami. Thank you so much. And with that, the 25 wins for tonight. Thank you so much, thank you so much, Senpai, for coming through. We really appreciate the games. It means a lot to me personally. Hey, Krusty Bullet. Tuning in from New Zealand? Wow. That's cool. Thank you so much for coming through. Must be later in that daytime. What time is it in New Zealand?
Craig Marduk.
Oh yeah, and Fang, definitely. I think our connection should be pretty solid. And that I'm on this side of the country, you know, I have better connections with West Coast players and mountain region players.
Get ready for the next battle.
Even when I play against players in Florida or in the Midwest, it's pretty solid. So I don't have any problems. It's not like I'm dying of lag or anything. New Zealand, 4 p.m. I know, right? They're already like done with the day almost. It's crazy.
Round one.
But thank you so much, Krusty.
Fight.
Chaka, chaka. Nice power push.
KO.
Can't do anything. I need help.
Round two. Fight.
Nice. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness.
Great.
I messed up on the
round three.
The combo.
Fight.
But instead of sidestepping the left, I sidestepped the right.
Go.
Nice stuff, Azure. Good stuff. Got yourself a win. 6:41 p.m. Yeah, wow. So, wow, it's already p.m. over there. That's crazy. That 18:41. That's 6:41 p.m. That's a hell of a time difference. How's the future looking, Krusty Bullet? Is the future looking pretty good so far? What happened to... I'll skip my turn here. Do you have viewer games? Yes, I do. A lot of times when I run these Thursday streams, Krusty, players who join these lobbies are viewers themselves. Oh, Shinigami's not there? Okay, oh well. Alright, well, we shall entertain the viewers with our match.
Welcome to the King, Craig Marduk.
I'm trying to play better neutral with Marduk, but I know. Worst case scenario, I can only throw out tackles, but I'm really trying not to be tempted. Tackle with the win button. Shinigami here. Oh, he was like setting up his stream or something. Dang, Shinigami. Gotta set up my stream first. Are you playing offline? Last year I played a little bit offline, Enfang. Haven't been to offline in this year though. Good catch. Yeah, watch my recovery kicks. Round 2.
Fight.
Can't buck the slide.
Round 3.
Both Phoenix and Fight. Tucson have offline scenes. So, and they're pretty good.
Perfect. Round 4. Fight.
Oh, I thought I stepped. Oh, nice down point. Wow, nice. Good stuff, Ed.
You lose.
I'm like, I'm trying to do something. Yes. Keep swinging. Can't do anything. Think Kane is in Tucson? Yes. I think Kane is also in Tucson. But he doesn't really... I think the only time I've seen him out And I wasn't even there for it, but he did recently go to Evo last year. He does any offline. He does basic streaming online. This character makes you mash? Hey, that's fine. I need to learn how to deal with it. That's on me. I need to work on dealing with the offense. And that's one thing I'm trying to work on with this character. Just get familiar with crazy playstyles. I think I still have an issue with wild playstyle, so I gotta not let it get to me. Play better defense.
Get ready for the next battle.
I feel the same way with Joji too. Joji sometimes makes me wanna press more.
Annie? Are you okay, Annie?
Round one. Fight.
You might go back to Albuquerque if they have a month. Wow, a 6 to 7 hour drive? Holy crap. I can't do those long drives anymore, Enfeng. I don't know how young or old you are, but I know I used to do that in the past, but not anymore. I think, VDX? He's in New Mexico these days, so pretty sure that he's been trying to go to locals when they have him.
Round two.
I didn't know that New Mexico actually had a scene. It's really nice. I'm trying to figure out, does Wyoming State, do they have a scene out there? North Dakota? South Dakota? Oh, 25. Okay, gotcha. Yeah, I'm in my 40s, Enfeng. So definitely, I'm in a different life right at the moment. I was the same way. I loved to travel when I was in my 20s. Great time. Had a lot of fun. Now it's like, okay, you know. I'm okay with not having to travel too much. This is fun for me. I'll go to some major tournaments here and there, but other than that, and maybe some locals if I can get a chance. Nice step. It's good to see a player who, you know, Shinigami here, Dane's Lee, and knows how to deal with the character. Of course, learning how to deal with the character with Jin is a different story.
Fight.
He knows the ins and outs of the character, so he knows what to look for. See the Azure here, just really just trying to dash in his face here. Definitely been on the younger end of the North America scene. There's a lot of 30 plus players have been playing this game for years. Yeah, exactly. So, and at least you have the advantage of being able to continue on. Once Tekken 8 comes out, then you can be really strong yourself in the particular Tekken game.
You've been hit back.
Wow, good games to Azure, very nice. Good games to Panda. But yeah, keep up the good work, Enfeng. And Kev BMM, how's it going? Good to see you in the chat. Thank you so much for coming through.
Welcome to the King of Iron, Craig Marduk.
Yep, no problem, yes. I was, again, same boat as you, just making sure that you have that work-life game balance. If you're still attending school and you're trying to work on that degree or whatever you're doing, definitely make sure that's priority number one. Of course, work too, because hey, what pays the bills? Games don't really pay the bills. We're not all me, we're not pros. You want your Chloe back? Dang. The things I do for education. Your butt is mine. Your butt is mine. No, no, no.
Fight.
That's not right. Step. I'll attack.
KO. Round 2. Fight.
20 minus. Minus 11. Down for two.
KO. Round 3. Fight.
Oh, that's back four.
Perfect.
Dang, I'm stuck. Can't move.
Round 4.
Cannot move.
Fight. Final round. Fight. Perfect.
Try to go for a side throw. It didn't work
you
out.
Win.
Good stuff, Azure. Good stuff. Sad. It's okay, man. It's okay.
Welcome to the King of Iron Fist Tournament, Craig Marduk.
I'm going to play one more myself, and then win or lose, I'll give Azure and Shinigami one more, and then we'll wrap it up for this evening. But again, thank you so much for coming through, folks. I really appreciate the games. It means a lot to me. A lot of times I'm hard-pressed to find time to play, and you guys make it worth it. Thank you. Always striving to get good in this game.
Get ready for the next battle.
Of course, first of 10 Fridays. We'll resume next Friday. I'm looking forward to it. Trying to get most of the schedule rearranged and also getting some additional sets set up for the following Fridays as well. So I'll miss y'all tomorrow since I won't be streaming, but we'll be back next week. How does Marta pick up a
round
car
one.
Like that? Jeez.
Fight.
Made out of aluminum? Man, I'll hop in a car. Upstairs? Oh crap. Oh,
KO. Round two. Fight.
Fuck. I got my health speed. Oh no.
KO.
That's a bad idea. Don't do that again.
Round three. Fight.
Oops, launch. Oh my goodness. I didn't think that was gonna hit me. That was nice.
KO.
Oh dang.
Round four. Fight.
Yeah. Nope. Oh, that left me. Nice.
KO.
Double lows. I should have known. How's it going, Sammy? Good to see you in the chat. Alright, this will be the last game of the evening. Can't react to down back three, unfortunately. I gotta make a read on that. And even then, Marduk doesn't have anything good to punish it. He can't do launch, because he doesn't have a while standing launcher from that. And also, you know, his up forward 1-2 doesn't work because Fang is still in crouch, so all he has is while standing 4, which is not a very good punish. So in most respects, I think Fang is a good matchup against Marduk. The lack of while standing punishment, you literally have to make the reads of low parry and stuff to make it more effective. That's where Marduk shines, is the low parry department. Down back three is an asshole low. Yeah. Shinigami, sure, you can have the raid. I'll definitely give it to you. Not a problem. Should have been here sooner, yeah. It would have been nice, Sammy. Of course, we had really good games. We had very high level games with a lot of players here earlier today.
Just show your face.
Bang's only bad matchup
fight
is arguably Eddie. Bang can't hit him that well. Yes, that's right. Shinigami definitely doing work. Azure has been on a Lee escapade here. Oh, nice down 4-2. We're gonna win. You're paralyzed, he says. Chew on this. All I want to say is close your eyes. I love it.
Fight.
Sammy's been practicing with boost a lot. Okay, that's cool. How's that coming along, Sammy? I need to hit boost up for some games too myself. Are you enjoying his armor king? Been very helpful? Good. Always good to hear. Well, backboard does not hit ground with this game.
KO. Round 3. Fight.
Before they actually grounded. And then they practically took a lot of her grounded stuff. Defense is really good, so you gotta be creative, yeah. That's what I love about players who, if they have good defense, and it's like, man, you know, how do you open them up? You gotta find, you know, potential holes or mistakes in movement. Oh no, the side throw, nice catch. Honestly, they really need to come up with some better throws.
KO. Round 4.
I love the side throws in the back throw. Maybe they just switch them. Make the front throws look like the back throws, and make the back throws look like the front throws, since nobody really uses the back throws as much. Change up the animations. And of course, throw breaks, of course. Oh yeah. Against a king player, armor king player, you gotta break some throws. I've been trying to work on not using tackle with Marduk. Oh! That was good catch! Dang! That was good read there, Banazra. Good read, good read. The win button. Target against AK. Got it. Awesome stuff. Alright. Good games, Asher and Shinigami. Thank you so much for coming through. And of course, really appreciate you staying up so late to get some games in. Alright. Well, with that said, folks, thank you so much for coming through. Whether you came in early or just recently, I really appreciate your support as always. Again, we won't be doing any First Attend Fridays tomorrow. I'll be taking a break to celebrate my wife's birthday over the weekend. And we will be back next Thursday for another session, and First Attend Fridays will resume next Friday. And don't forget to join the Discord. Azure here has gracefully put the link in here. If you haven't joined the Discord yet, please join. Otherwise, I'm gonna send you over to Shinigami Panda. He'll be streaming. Have a wonderful evening, folks, and a greater weekend. Peace out, y'all.